Hey guys, Angel's Graveyard here. That's right, we had a name change, so yeah. But today we're gonna be looking at Spirit Halloween 2024 animatronic leak. Alrighty, the first one we're gonna be looking at is called Dark Princess. And this one here, from what I'm looking at, she's really cool. I love her face, I love the sculpt that she has. Her hands look a little funky. I like the wings. She's basically a reskin of the bat from last year. I forgot his name. It's like demonic or something like that. But I really like what she has. Like her face and everything. I think she looks amazing. I love the pop-up feature. I'm kind of on the fence about getting her. I might get her, I might not. I don't know, depending on how much she is, I may or may not get her.
This is the point of no return. Your cries and screams are futile.
Next up, we got Demonic Gatekeeper. I'm reading off my list here. So, Demonic Gatekeeper, he is a groundbreaker, and he is, I don't know how tall he is, but he looks humongous. He fogs, and his mouth moves. He's pretty cool. I personally wouldn't get him. I have a graveyard theme. He would fit into the theme, but personally, I'm not really a huge groundbreaker person. But he's not too bad, and I think he's going to be a cool one this year. Next up we have Defray. Now this guy is interesting to say the least. He is 10 feet tall, I know that for sure, which is humongous. His chest lights up and he moves his head and he turns. He's basically a towering animatronic. He looks decent, I guess. He's definitely a more interesting guy for sure. I wouldn't get him personally because he wouldn't fit in with my theme, but I'm sure he'll find a home with someone.
Yum, yum, yum! Sometimes it's sweet, sometimes it's not! One thing I'll tell you though, it'll do more than rot your teeth out! Ha
Next up we have Cotton Candy Dan. Now this one is the one that we saw in the Spirit Leak video, like the cotton candy thing. And he's not as bad as I thought he was gonna be. He's actually pretty decent. He's a clown. Wouldn't be picking him up because he doesn't fit in with the theme, but he's not a bad animatronic at all. Next up, we have Graveyard Ghoul. Now, this guy I might pick up if I have any spare money left over with a coupon, because he is like a graveyard person and he has a tombstone that says, "In the memory of our dead friend, of our dear friend." And he thrashes around. He's kind of like if a tortured torso was grounded on the ground and had a tombstone, which is interesting. He's not a super bad animatronic. He's more of the cheaper, probably. He's probably going to be more of the cheaper ones this year, but not bad.
Ha 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 ha
Next up, we have Max Straw, which, don't get it confused with Jack Straw, but this guy is interesting. He looks a lot like Sam, if you know what I mean, Sam from Trick or Treat. He's a floating animatronic, like what Home Depot did with the witch. He has a pitchfork, I think that is, and he just kind of, I think he turns his head and just speaks, which is pretty cool. He's not one that I would probably pick up even if he was on theme, just because he looks a little goofy to me, like a little, you know. But anyways, he's not too bad of a prop. I like his giant hail bale necklace that he has, or like reef necklace thingy that he has. His pitchfork does look pretty cool, and I like the tethered on his robe. So yeah, he's not super bad, but then again, I will change my mind once I see him in store.
Cross the threshold where the dead walk free. Enter, and in the darkness you will find me.
Next up, I don't know this guy's name. I looked all over and I could not find him, but take that with a grain of salt, because I wasn't really looking, because I just kind of looked on YouTube videos and they didn't have his name in the description. So I was just like, because they had everyone else's name but not his, so he's gonna go by question mark now. But this guy's really cool. I love him. I have a feeling he's gonna be online exclusive, probably. He's really cool. I love the fire effect that he has on the skull and on his robe. It's kind of like a black heart mixed with, like, I'm forgetting the name of the animatronic, but it's kind of like a Blackheart-esque animatronic, which is pretty cool. I really like him, and I feel like if you paired him up with Fog, he would look pretty cool. Next up, we have Night Terror. Whenever I first saw this guy, I was like, what is this? He's very goofy. He's kind of like a, whatchamacallit? Oh shoot, I'm forgetting the animatronic. I'm forgetting all the animatronics. I'm forgetting the name. It's the pumpkin animatronic that like spins around. Not spins around, but like has like the motion that goes like that. He was like 2017 or 2018, I think, but no, not 2017. He was like 2016. I'm like getting my years off, but yeah, that's what he reminds me of. Probably not one I'd pick up, but you know, people have their preferences.
You teach a class about slashers and you still walked into a dark alley alone. Strange that you and I have never spoken on the phone. This is long overdue.
Next we have Ghostface, and I love, 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 love Ghostface. The animatronic? Not so much. His robe is that material that's just kind of like that. Ugh, material, you know what I mean? It's hard to describe. It's like that smooth material that like wrinkles really easily. So if I get him, I might replace his robe with one of my spare robes I have, because I feel like that'd be easier. But he comes with interchangeable knives and interchangeable masks. Mask which I'm showing here, which is the bloody mask, which is from Scream 6, and then it's just the basic white mask with the machete, and then here we have the Buck 120, I'm guessing, and the H mask from Scream 6. First voice line is whenever the first character gets killed. I'm forgetting her name as well. I'm like blinking on everything. And then the second voice line is Gale and Ghostface on a phone call. on the topic of crossovers, we are looking at Michael Myers next. I think he looks really good. Spirit did a really good job. He looks real. I really like it. I like his mask. I like his body shape. I like it. I like it all. I think it's a really good animatronic. I won't be buying Michael Myers just because I'm not really a huge person on the movies. I've seen the movies. I'm just not overly excited about the movies. Obviously, you can see I like Ghostface a lot. So I definitely probably will be picking up Ghostface. But Michael Myers, I might pick him up. Maybe. That's a hard maybe. But not too shabby. Once again, with the crossovers, we're going to be talking about Emily and Victor next. They don't have videos with them yet, but I'm excited to see them. Emily looks amazing. I love the blue fading from the white fading to the blue at the bottom of the dress. I love her face. They did an amazing job. Her wig looks lovely. Her veil looks lovely. Her flowers look lovely. They just did an overall good job with her. And then Victor, he looks lovely as well. His face is good. His outfit is accurate. And he has the ring in his hand, which is accurate. So nothing else I can say about them, but really good, and it's basically probably going to be like the Sally and Jack animatronic from a few years ago. So yeah, nothing, no hate about them at all. Next up, we have Towering. Get ready for this. Towering Tallulah. And I'm guessing she's going to be a Mr. Dark reskin. Get a closer look of her. She's not too bad. She's, I feel like she's more on the cheaper side, but she's not, like, horrible, but I probably wouldn't be picking her up, but, yeah, she has green creepy cloth, which is interesting. You don't see green creepy cloth a lot, and then a brown underskirt, and then gray hair, and I believe a hat on her as well. I just can't see in the